What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Jay coming at you with some ideas. This isn't a review. This is actually a pitch meeting. This is a way to give life to an old property while staying original as possible in a remake. But after the vastly inferior remake, every Fredhead has been wondering, when are we going to get an actually good remake in the future? With the very sad passing of horror icon Wes Craven, the Nightmare on Elm Street rights have gone back to the Wes Craven estate. There, they've been in talks of hearing ideas on how to bring Freddy back. Well, this is your boy Jay, Fredhead extraordinaire, and I'm going to dive into how to revitalize this franchise. Let's get into it. Alright, one major gripe I hear about the 2010 remake is the fact it ripped direct scenes from the original. The bathtub scene, Chris's death, the body bag scene, the list goes on. The thing is, you don't want to be so original that it creates new and unwanted lore for the characters. 2010 failed miserably at this. How would I revitalize this franchise? Is by doing what Halloween 2019 did. They picked up right after the first movie. No, I wouldn't bring back Heather Langenkamp to play Nancy. She died in Dream Warriors. It's not that I don't like Heather. She's wonderful. Met her in person. She is a great person. But I would recast a female to play Nancy. Someone that resembles Heather, though. I would also not just do a remake of the original. I would have to think about totally new storylines which would come from the original. Like, let's say, starting off with what happened to Nancy between the first and the third film. I would start off with narration, something along the lines of Alice from Resident Evil. The female's voice being Nancy, giving someone her name and her information. Come to find out, Nancy's talking to a doctor. Imagine if Nancy was taken to a psychiatric hospital after the events of the first movie. Kinda like Dream Warriors, cause in Dream Warriors you had Kristen going to the psychiatric ward, but this movie it would be Nancy. During her intake, she goes over the events that transpired in the first movie, actually having to rehash POV. You know, talking to the doctor about Tina's death, running to the police station to see Rod hanging, her during Glenn's death, a rehash of the final battle between her and Freddy, Freddy's demise, and so on. The intake evaluation would end with her seeing her mother suck through the window as the car took the teens away, POV Nancy. Back to the present, the doctor's trying to convince Nancy that what she witnessed with her mother was a dream. Her mother died from smoking in her bed. The fire marshal determined she had died from falling asleep with a lit cigarette. Her toxicology report also showed alcohol in her system. The doctor brings out the red diary from her closet, which was retrieved by authorities after the Walsh family abruptly vacated the 1428 Elm Street residence. The doctor goes on to tell Nancy that Rod killed Tina and killed himself in jail. Nancy asked the doctor to explain Glenn. The doctor could not. We find out Nancy is back at the Katna Institute for the Study of Sleep Disorders from the original movie. They are admitting her to the psychiatric ward to study her dreams in order to find the suppressant to combat them. This is where we will eventually be introduced to Hypnosil toward the end. The psychiatric ward consists of 8 other residents who will eventually be cannon fodder throughout the movie. Those individuals will also have a history linking their parents to the murder of Krueger. Throughout the movie, Nancy discovers the fact she can control powers in her dreams from one of the residents in the ward. This is why Nancy was able to tell Dream Warriors about it in A Nightmare on Elm Street 3. Some kids die by being put under by the doctors running clinical trials on them and the drug not working. One by one, the teens are picked off in their dreams until it's up to Nancy and 3 others to go into the dream to stall Freddy long enough so the doctors and the chemists can correct Hypnosil so it works and to set up to bring Freddy out of the dream to kill him. I would take the lore from Wes Craven's New Nightmare. Freddy is this evil entity that inhabits the body of Freddy Krueger at birth. In the teen's dream, each teen sees Freddy differently. Some see him as the Freddy from the original movie. Some see him as the Freddy from Dream Master. Some see him as the Freddy from Wes Craven's New Nightmare. Some people even see the Jackie Earl Haley Freddy in their dreams. The only thing which are constant throughout each victim's dreams are the red and green sweater, the hat, the burned face, and the razor glove. Honestly, who would vision Freddy the same if you were told in a group about him? The only time Freddy reveals his true form, the Paul Bailey form, is during the final confrontation with this movie's dream warriors, going into the dream and meeting him together. Kinda like an It type of vibe. That's when the Paul Bailey Freddy stalks the four teens by splitting them up in the dream, kinda like Dream Warriors. The teens, knowing his true form, now can see him in his true form. Two teens die in a dark, nightmarish scene, killing them in a manner personal to them. During the battle, Nancy and the second teen manage to grab a hold of Freddy to bring him out of the dream at the Sleep Institute. It works. Now Freddy is on the loose. He gets free in the hospital, searching for the doctor and the chemist who are working on the drug. Freddy finds them and slashes the chemist, leaving him mortally wounded in the final stage of the drug's completion. The doctor, Nancy, and the other survivor manage to kill Freddy in the real world as the doctor checks the completion of the compound. After the compound is complete, the chemist dies from his wound. The end of the story leaves Nancy going on her own path and the doctor and the other survivor going their separate ways. Doing it this way can branch the franchise to where they don't feel like they have to follow in the footsteps of the original series. We can now follow the path of the other survivors instead of Nancy's path that will eventually lead to Dream Warriors. Following the other survivors will open the door for sequels that are original and not remakes of the classic sequels. Anyway, that's my take on how the Craven Estate can revitalize this franchise while paying homage to the original, while also leaving the door open for sequels in the future. This gives fans that loosely based Dream Warriors remake people have been asking for. It's not a shot-by-shot remake, but it is a revisiting of Dream Warriors. It also tells Fred Heads what happened to Nancy between the first and the third movie. It ties in Jesse and Lisa, making Freddy's Revenge canon to the series. It repackages a horror franchise so it can be introduced to a new generation properly. Most importantly, it will give true fans of the original series answers while giving us something to look forward to in the sequels to come. So what do you think about my ideas? Do you think this would be a great way to reboot the Nightmare on Elm Street franchise? Let me know what you guys think about it in the comments below. If you have any ways that Freddy could come back, please share them in the comments. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button and the bell so that you don't miss anything Splatter Talk Cinema Review related. But with that being said, I want to take a moment to just hope and pray that everybody is taking the time to protect themselves during this time of crisis in the United States and worldwide. I hope that everybody and their families are safe and they are doing their social distancing. And while you're doing that, stuck at home, hey, you could be listening to Splatter Talk Cinema Review. Well, anyway, this is your boy Jay, Splatter Talk Cinema Review. It's a wrap.